Hi everyone, today let's discuss about Samudragupta, the emperor of the Gupta dynasty who ruled from 335 to 380 Common Era. He was the son of Chandragupta I. His mother Kumara Devi belonged to the Lich Chavigana. Iran's stone inscription states that his father selected Samudragupta as the successor because of his devotion, righteous conduct and valor. His Allahabad inscription similarly describes how Chandragupta called his son Samudragupta a noble person in front of the courtiers and appointed him to protect the earth. In Allahabad inscription or Samudragupta's Prashasti, which is written in praise of the king, Hari Sen praised the king in glowing terms as a warrior and as a king who won victories in battle. Referring to Samudragupta, it says, whose body was most charming, being covered with the plenteous beauty of the marks of hundreds of scars caused by battle axes, arrows, spikes, long arrows and many other weapons. In the long inscription at Allahabad, the poet enumerates the people and countries conquered by Samudragupta. Hari Sen describes four different kinds of rulers and tells us about Samudragupta's policies towards them. First is the rulers of Aryavart. The area, as you can see in the map, which is shaded in green, here there are 9 rulers who were uprooted and their kingdoms were made a part of Samudragupta's empire. Secondly, the rulers of Dakshinapath. They surrendered to Samudragupta after being defeated and he then allowed them to rule again. Maybe because of the distance, the kingdoms of Dakshinapath were not made part of the main empire of Samudragupta. Thirdly, the inner circle of neighboring states. They brought tributes, followed the orders of Samudragupta and attended his court. And lastly, the rulers of the outlying areas. They were the one who submitted to Samudragupta and offered daughters in marriage to maintain good relations with Gupta Empire. If we believe the eulogistic inscription from Allahabad, it would appear that Samudragupta never knew any defeat. And because of his bravery and generalship, he is called the Napoleon of India. But at the same time, we have to be very cautious about using Prashasti as the source of information, because these prashastis were written only in praise of the ruler and the negative side or any defeat are often not mentioned in these prashastis. The Allahabad pillar inscription suggests that Samudragupta's aim was the unification of the earth, which suggests that he may have aspired to become a Chakravartin, that is, a universal ruler. The Mathura stone inscription of Chandragupta II describes Samudragupta as an exterminator of all kings and as a person whose fame was tasted by the waters of all four oceans. With all these military expeditions and territorial expansion, Samudragupta ensured a well-managed administrative structure. As the Allahabad inscription states that he maintained strict administration, that is, Prachanda Shasana. Samudragupta's reign also witnessed patronage to art and literature. Samudragupta is represented on his coins playing the lute or veena. Poet Hari Sen also describes Samudragupta as a king who was learned and the best of poets. This suggests that Samudragupta must have composed some poetical works, but sadly, none of these works now survive. Moving on to another interesting fact related to Samudragupta's reign. Samudragupta was the first Gupta ruler to mint coins. These were the imitation of the coinage of the Kushana Empire, adopting its weight standard, techniques and designs. The Guptas even adopted the name of Dinara from the Kushana coinage. Though, the term Dinara basically came from the name of the Roman coins, Denarius Aureus. Have a look at the pictures of Samudragupta's coins. You get a variety of descriptions and depictions on Samudragupta's coins, portraying different shades of his life. The archer and battle axe coin types of Samudragupta showcase his physical power and strength, while his depiction with Veena represents a completely different aspect of his personality. We also see various titles used by Samudragupta. For example, Parakrama, that is like a tiger in strength, Apratirath, that is great warrior, Kritanti Parashu, that is axe of death. Moving on to another aspect of Samudragupta's reign, that is religion. Samudragupta's Iran inscription records the installation of a Vishnu idol in a temple. The Nalanda and Gaya inscriptions attributed to Samudragupta mention him as a devotee of Vishnu, that is Parama Bhagavata. At the same time, he was tolerant towards Buddhism and permitted the construction of a Buddhist monastery at Bodh Gaya, commissioned by a Sri Lankan king. Besides all this, Samudragupta is considered as a compassionate ruler who cared a lot for the welfare of his subjects, particularly the poor and the destitute. This is all about Samudragupta. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe for more such academic videos.